Well, good afternoon, everybody. Welcome back to the Blackguard. We are 54% of the way to 75, and we have a wonderful 793 war crests. So everything is going in the right direction. We finished off our weekend scenario doodah last night. It was a lot of fun. I quite enjoyed it, I have to say. I actually did it on the chopper for a bit, which was weird. But today, we are hopefully going to get our RVR week stuff finished out and get some of that juicy, juicy renown. But we'll see how we go. That's the worst that can happen. Probably loads, but a blob coming this way, apparently. Haha! I escaped the blob. That is a real blob. I love how they're just leaving their tail to die. Oh, they're now getting pushed from the other side. I helped. That's what I'm gonna say. Blob on blob action. That's what everybody wants to see. Isn't it? That's just starting to cap everything. Might go to A10 because there's AO and A10. We'll see what we can get out of here. Oh, what's this? Slowed. Ah, come on, let me get my knockdown. Oh, of course it goes away as soon as she stops. Huzzah, we did it. We all did a thing. Oh, craggy. Give me a minute. I didn't realize that was as low down as it was. Hey, Anonymous, how's things, bud? Hopefully you're having a nice day. There's the cat. There's the man. These could be his hands. He's stroking the cat. It's hell inside my head at times. Got my 10 event scenarios on my Archmage. Now I logged in on my Zerg. You're really going for it, in other words. And everybody is dead. We're just getting farmed. Where'd he go? Oh, he's dead. Come on, give me the Shadow Warrior. Longest respawn timer in history. Hey, I got the protection score. Go me. Was only a thing for half of it. Comfortably as well. That's surprising. Nearly 800. The old war crest. What the? Locked in. Yeah. It's like, no, you're not allowed to enter RVR today. I don't know what it is with gates. They seem to bug every now and again because you get it a lot in Inevitable City with the gates leading down to the Undercroft, where like one of them will bug and you can't get through it, so you have to go around through the Slaanesh Quarter to get out. And I can't remember it ever happening in the live game, so it must be a bug just with the way this works. How rude. Damn, Destro queue times are long. Yeah, they can be. If it's not level 40, I don't know, it can take forever sometimes. Witch Hunter. You think my Sork isn't 40? I don't know. But like they're popping pretty quickly for me. And I'm 40, so. Well, so this is my second scenario in the space of 10 minutes. I often find anytime I play any of my level 30s or below, I can't seem to get scenarios popping quicker than about one every 40 minutes. I don't know whether it's just a case of people just don't want to do scenarios and they want to try and level a different way or something. But it's just one of those annoying things. Thought I was gonna make it. Well, that's what it feels like to be knocked down by an Ironbreaker and then set upon by every DPS known to man. You're in the wrong scenario. That's a matter of opinion. I'm in the right scenario for me. The problem with it is you'll probably find there's an awful lot of people who've already done the scenario. And unlike most weekends, it doesn't give anything for the pre-mades. So they're all just spread out amongst all of the other ones. 44 to 56, I see. No wonder Destro queues are so long. I don't know. I usually find that whenever there's a higher Destro population, scenarios pop quicker because Order don't want to go out into the field. They just want a turtle and a keep. I love that he drank a potion and he had like tons of health. That's him dead. Ooh, 7K. I've met plenty of bitch elves that are after I open on them, they stagger, drink potion and stuff. Yeah. The problem is, like, witch elves and witch hunters can do that. In fact, in a lot of cases, they don't even need to do that. Because they'll just reheal as soon as they open on you. There's a ton of tier 3 event scenario parties. Nobody in tier 4 seems to want to do it. It's because it's not given renown. Everybody in tier 4 is only interested in the renown. I want my cape. Heck an event, I have to rely on TomToms to get my cape. Well, what you could do is you could get a bunch of your guildies together and you could do it. They're all running boxes. It's weird to have a split between Etain and Cadrin. I don't think they care, and the Destro side has been quite empty lately. All right. Maybe it'll pick up later on. Look at random people standing on a hill. I don't know, there's no AAO at the minute. It's all leaving. It's 25 to 99 for each side. Just give it a few hours for the EU mindless erg to log in. I don't know, I usually find on Saturdays it's order biased. Unless there's Land of the Dead. When is Land of the Dead? 7 days. I might go over to 18. Yeah, because the order numbers are starting to drop here. Yeah, I'm not waiting for 1 hour per scenario. Guess I only got one cape. You never know, bud. It might pick up. You could try doing a shout out in LFG and see if anybody wants to form a group. Only one shot was spammed the LFG for tier 3. Yeah, okay. Oh, I'll log into my witch hunter for them desperate snacks. Hopefully you can get some renown. How have we now got AAO in Cadron Valley? That makes no sense. Oh, it's because all the order are coming back. I see. Sixty%. They're really flooding this zone. Order Zerg. Poor little Destro's outnumbered. Order bound roaming around our fort. Our fort? We're in their end zones. Oh, scheiße. That's what he means. Our keep, not our fort. Now, I wonder, does this work? Let's see. It does. Love That's one way to keep the part and get it handed in. Tasty, tasty, renown. Just making sure there that neither one of them was a melee one. Oh, good. The one I guarded's left. Oh no. Still here, apparently. But left. Huh? I'm so confused. Jet lads sit and hold the flag. I don't get it. Like, why run over there to die? Look at them. They've literally all just killed themselves. Rather than standing here and fighting on the flag. Useless buggers. No way, that should have interrupted him. Okay. That was our chance. We blew it. Someone's here. There's a witch elf. Maybe there's nobody here. Okay. Where's D7 we're at now? Really does seem to take forever. At this level. Some sort of fighting down here. But what will it be? Dwarves, most likely. Someone decapped it. So, witch hunters? What's that? Oh, it's Blackguard. Synchronized horn blowing. Guard circ. I think these were the ones we were up against before. They seem to be a premium.
Come on.
Shame. Go away. Only order tanks are tanky. I love stopping advice. Hey, Asterice, how's things, bud? Hopefully you're having a nice day. Let me click police straw. Damn it. Ignore this non-team play environment. Advice chat always makes me chuckle. There's some class lines in it. Ha! I can't get caught in an environment if I jump over it. Captain Insano. Oh, he thought better of it. Now he's got the backup of a team, he has the courage of a lion. There's Billy's strip. Killed by me. So that doesn't count for order. They don't get renowned for that. I killed myself. Technically, I should get the renown in the war crests. Can you imagine a world where tanks that get killed by their own guard got the credit for the kill? Like, you'd never not see a tank guarding someone. You'd see them actively guard swapping. It would be quite funny. Hey, Mr. Protectobot. I like to think it was me guarding him, allowed Kalistra to get a kill. Hey, we're into the 800s again. Oh, keeps nearly at 3-star. I'd sit at Inevitable City on a livey myself with my Zork. Only, oh, it should only count for tanks with guard, not Zorks. Zorks get enough. I like to think that was a bug at some point. Like early in the development of the game, it was like tanks would gain renown and XP from killing themselves. It sounds like the sort of bug that you would see. Oh, we've got a difference out of order this time. Come on, little marauder, we can do it. Woo! Ah. Oh. Hey, I died alongside the other blackguard. There we are. We're twinsies. He's like, get away from me. I don't want to be associated with you. You're blue. Got him. Boo. Death to Pyru. On your knees is the leveling build. Is it? For a witch elf? Leveling high, though. Why won't it let me guard? Oh, there we go. There you go. Okay. Being outdone by the chosen on protection. Sads. Right, let's see. To the right, I think. Still tiddling along rightly with our orc rests. More things to fire off to the sort when we're finished as well. Yoink. Double yoink. Stealing all their things. I quit. Oh, you gotta love it. I don't want to be here. How are we doing on our influence? I haven't checked that yet. Still a bit to go. I'm gonna hop over to E10. Get some of that sweet, sweet AAO. And of course, it's put me in a PvE camp. Because why would it not? Oh, yeah, I can't join Slurs. Sads. That's a big old line. Larentar. Little Zulu. Doesn't really feel like either of these zones are moving. Because Cadron's now 3-3. Etienne's 2-2. I'd imagine that's going to end up 3-3. So I'm not really sure what the plan is. Kind of feels like they're just setting it up for later on. Oh, Probably are, since warband leaders don't want the siege, they want to sit at the war camp and kill trade. Yeah. That's half the problem, though. In a lot of cases, Destro don't know how to push. So they kind of need overwhelming numbers before they even try it. Aha! Well, that's Jupy. I haven't seen Jupy in ages. That was a waste of a potion. Hilda. Right, I'm going to take a quick 5 minute, well, 5 minute, 1 minute break. I shall be back in 2 seconds. See you in a bit. And I'm back. Oh, nearly allowed back in scenarios. Fairly sure I clicked that. Game trying to con me out of drinking an armor potion. Oh, they've got a ram. It's DPS Blackguard. He laughs out loud at Zell. Why? Like, you're running around solo, is this not what you're after? Ah! Target is out of range. It's a lot of order. Run, little Zell. Let your legs carry you to freedom. Lot of order. Oh, they have a massive Zerg. They have over 100 people. Typical order. Always Zerging. All I ever get told is it's constant Destro. Destro! Anytime I log in, regardless of the time of day, it's just order everywhere. Feel like it's all a propaganda campaign. Well, they all fight over that bridge. I'll just walk over this one. He's like, how did you see me? I am in stealth. I'm also a witch hunter and an endless parry. Oh, that bugger escaped. Look at the lion running away. Bloody white lions. Zerg arrived at ATM. Time to go to Cavern Valley, I guess. Can you not repair it anymore? Hey Rav, how's things, bud? KV has zero Destro. I'd like to formally challenge you to a 1v1 once I have my Bloodlord set. Ah, can't even see anything with that cannon. I was gonna say, I wondered why no one's using it. Since when do witch hunters have knockbacks? All good. Been fooled yet today? Nope, not so far. Problem with it is, like, it used to be a case of people used to really put decent effort into April Fool's pranks, but the problem with it is now is a lot of the big corporations are too afraid of the backlash if they do something that someone's actually going to fall for. So it's all really obvious. It does work. Okay. I managed to hit one person, I think. Sovereign ability. Ah, okay. Was gonna say, I didn't think they normally had knockbacks. Seems almost counterintuitive for a witch hunter to have a knockback. And he ran away. There's someone leaving. Oh, I can sign up for scenarios again. Never liked these swords that have like the guard around the hand. No idea why. Just never have. Less Destro in the zone after siege than before, a bit weird. That's probably all cross roamers. It's the classic thing, push a zone to get your renown and stuff on one character, and then push it back on the other. There we go, finally out of guards to Buffhead. Can now see instantly who's gripped up. Also finally got Buffhead. I used to use add-ons on live, but I just can't be bothered getting them all set up and configured. In the Buffhead 2 now. Maybe. Like, there's really not that many people in the zone for us. Like, there's no even open warband. The sad thing about it is, like, there is no sense in me actually defending this keep because I'll not get anything for it. Now you're safe, it's Deathblow 2. What kind of cheap plugin is that? It's one where you just select a target and then you press a key and it automatically kills them, but it makes it look like you did it normally. It's how Rav levels all of his characters. The Ragnarok wrap is the only reason I'm doing it. It looks great. Fashion hammer. Go team. Also, finally made a default UI I can copy to any character. To be honest, I used to do that. And then I just got fed up every time I would put it onto one and I'd want to change something. Being a baseline I can find, shouldn't it? Yeah. Whatever works for you, dude. Like, my warrior priest and the archmage wants the party window near the character. My witch hunter does not. Yeah, your witch hunter doesn't want to be near a party. Unless it's other witch hunters. Block the door, you skinny elf. Eh. I would, but like, let's face it, what's the point? We're all going to die a horrible, horrible death. We're all gonna die. We really are. Like, there's not even a warband here, right? We've got a chopper spamming attacks in front of the postern. We have a Sork running around in the lord room. A Doc pondering the meaning of life. And another Blackguard. Versus everyone else on the server by the looks of things. To be fair, if I see other witch hunters skulking about, I also linger around to focus the same target. I've noticed witch hunters actually attack good targets. If I try to help a bright wizard or a shadow warrior, they're just fire at tanks. Yeah. To be fair, though, you'll find that there's witch hunters and witch elves do the exact same thing. Like, it is insanely annoying the amount of times that you'll find just everybody hammering away at a tank who's got like three dedicated healers. Oh yeah, 100%, the witch hunter is a miles better class. Like, I think I was saying it to Tosh the other week, like, I have a baby witch elf in tier 1 and I have my witch hunter in tier 1, and the witch hunter is outdoing her on everything that you can think of. Like, he can take on multiple opponents at once. He can burn through pretty much anything. And she has to still pick her targets. And it has to be 1v1. And every now and again she'll get away with a 1v2. And like, in my mind, the problem in tier 1, at least, is that opener from stealth. Like, to burn away, I think it's 330 armor or something like that. That's insane at that level. And that'll scale obviously as it gets bigger. So, like, compare that to the opener that the Witch Elf has, which is if you do a melee attack, you'll take a small amount of damage. It's like, eh? Like, an armor debuff and damage is better than every time you use a melee ability, take a little bit of damage back. That was fun. Where do you get 7 second parry? That's the morale one, I think. If you're using repel, blasphemy, and parry morale, aren't you fighting 1v2 already? Almost all witch hunters I see use M1 parry straight after repel, blasphemy. Yeah. They're fighting a melee class, they've just got it up constantly. To be honest, Severed Nerve is fine as a starter morale, but like once you get higher up the levels, it's like you don't need it anymore. Always love it when you have a doc who just runs off on their own. Once I have my Bloodlord set, I'll go for Burn Away the Lies build and just nuke everything. Destro literally had this in the bag and they've thrown it away. Something shocking. $7,000, not bad. I just poured it in the middle of a battle. Bye. Ah, crap. I'm in the PvE camp again. Hey, we're at 62%. Fear me, cat. Oh no, I can't loot it. Monsters. What's the Lord at? 79. It's gonna be too long to wait. Ooh, border supplies in the sea. Don't mind if I do. Proving the point, you can find supplies everywhere you go. And get stuck in anything wherever you go. Find a CNT run. Is that like bile rot? Dark elves stick together. Sentinel dungeon. Ah, okay. Hopefully you can get some decent gear out of it. I have to go back and do Balrog Burrows at some point. I need to get my glaive. I have two runs, I think, left for the quest and two runs of Bastion Stairs for the quest. Ah, nice, dude. Then my warrior priest is all kitted out in Bloodlord. Cool. Does Bloodlord do not give you like a detriment to your... Is it your armor or something like that? Bloodlord and Beastlord. Don't ignore the second BL. I thought you were just saying like Bloodlord armor and Bloodlord weapons. Bloodlord is a good DPS set. It's actually solid for two-handers. I've heard it's supposed to be good for witch elves. I don't know how true that is, but I've only looked at it the once. I'm in a party by myself. Hey, we've got backup. Eesh. What did I command? I found the forums for Witchbrew. I got 10 IDs for the enemy add-on. Will any of the 10 work? They still haven't taken the Lord? Like they were on 11%. Did they get reset? I think they got reset. What's this chasing me? It's a witch hunter. Random throwing dagger just at the end that goes 5 miles. Hey, they finally got it. Ah! Good fight. Hey, there's our event complete. Oh, we're getting a bag. To the inevitable city. Yeah, sorry, I haven't added a buff head. Shoes all I need. Didn't even know you could add. Huh. I usually just sort of stick my finger in the air and go, should I parry now or not? If my finger gets chopped off, I go, yeah, I will parry. And if it doesn't, I go, I won't. Hello. I think that's all of the events complete now, right? So that's that one done. That one done. Nice. What are we like for crests? Oh, we're nearly at 1,000. Nommy nom noms. Oop, nearly walked off the edge. That would have been embarrassing. Well, that's how I check the oven. Stick my arm in there and see if it's warm or not. You do it as well? Buffhead already has base animation and timer. Ah, okay. I know nothing about any of the add-ons. Like, all I can remember from live is pure to turn this into like a little green and yellow bar. Booker grudges to track kills and deaths. And what was the other one? Key here for key and scenarios. I can't think of any others off the top of my head. I need a witch elf friend to aid me.
Step right up.
Step right up.
Pleasure doing business.
Enemy pure phantom for my yeah, and then a few others. Ah, nice dude. I think I'm going to take advantage of this AAO, and I'm going to jump over onto one of the other characters. Oh, no, I'm not. I'm going to get my bag. I forgot I was getting a bag. Literally said it mere minutes ago, and then I was like, I forgot. 936. Good times. Zell has a witch elf. I do. I don't think I'm specced for Witch Brew, though. But I can do it for you if you need to. I It's worse than that, Rav, because I've got a Blackguard, a Witch Elf, a Sork, and a Duck. And then I've got a Blackguard, a Witch Elf, and a Duck. So, you know. No need to... No, I'm about to enter CNT. Ah, no worries, dude. Let's do some Witch Elfy stuff anyway. I was tempted to jump on the Zealot, but I'll do the Witch Elf. She'll get more use out of solo roaming around with AoE. AoE? AO. Why do I keep calling it AoE? Dragon Wink. I swear to God, if this puts me in a PvE camp, I'm going to cry. You jump on a Zealot, I'll also do that Geo Zealot roaming. Nothing will ever kill us, but we'll never kill anything. I have two unread messages. Must be Warcrests. Oh no, it's a bag in Warcrests. Tell you what, I'm getting bags all over the show. Do I want Genesis Crests or do I want Warcrests? Warcrests.
I have a task for you.
Ours is indeed the Fury. Right. Some scenarios as well. So I changed her build, actually. I think it was a couple of weeks ago now. It's all around the idea of ignoring their armor and using Ruthless Assault. I have no idea if it's going to work or not. Kind of hoping it will, but... yeah. The problem with it is, I don't have Black Lotus Blade. And anytime you fight a healer, it feels like if you don't have it, you're just not doing anything to them. You might as well just be standing tickling them. Level is just 61, so I think she has the Invader Gem with 63. So couple more to go on that. I think with her, what I'm probably going to do is try and hybridize Invader and then one of the what do you call them? Scenario sets, either Triumphant or Victorious. Just for the extra bonuses. But that is a long, long way off. There's a geo roaming team you want, of healers, two chamois. I love that look for the black orc. Just looks like a giant tank. That's the thing, if more Black Orc armor looked like that, I'd be tempted to actually level one up. Oh good, we're being farmed. Look at that epic amount of XP and renown. Wah. That's the stuff dreams are made of right there. Dun, dun. Oh, I can't do that while I'm stealth. Deed. I didn't even see those other ones over there. That's my problem with the Witch Elf. Every time I jump somebody out of stealth, they always end up like miles away from me. Anytime a Witch Hunter will jump me out of stealth, even if I'm in like a mount going full tilt, it's like they're always right on top of me. I suppose I should take this my opportunity to actually drink my renown potion. Ta-doo. Looking for mega DPS. Oh, I love it. always find it funny when you see groups like this coordinated running boxes. That's such a weird sight to see. Like, it makes perfect sense if you're wanting to level up a keep, but it's such a weird, weird sight to see. This is where I miss having Kumis. I can just be stealth forever. Trees on the other side. Boo. He's all happy. That engineer's on the hiding to nothing. Got him. That's my problem. In a situation like that, I just don't seem to be able to get through their healing. Maybe I just need to switch between kisses, depending on who I'm fighting. You're killed by Durantress. Clearly some sort of Duran Duran fan. Damn it, I'm stuck. Actually get any kills in that? One. Haha! I'm on par with my blackguard. Sorry, went quiet, got three scenario pops after each other. That's okay, dude. Never feel obliged to have to chat. If you just want to chill out and watch, you can quite happily do that. I don't mind. I usually chat though, even when people ask me not to. That's all good, dude. You can chat as much or as little as you want. I really don't mind. I'm not one of these streamers who needs everybody to be sitting full on chatty catty. And equally, I'm not one of the ones he wants everybody to be quiet. So I've just realized this is our keep and I've just used my lockpick to get inside it because I'm an idiot. Oh god. Points for paying attention lost again.
No.
How's it going, Shay? Were you enjoying attempting to hurt my poor little witch elf? That went well. Say if I'd have been a witch hunter, he'd have been right on top of me. I'd have been knocked down, and that would have been it. Tonight, I have one more scenario before dinner break, but now pop is not happening. It's always the way, dude. The amount of times I've sat here and I've gone, one more scenario. 30 minutes later, I'm still sitting here going, just one more. You hadn't attacked a team member, I would have let it slide. I mean, I didn't have a choice. It's a scenario. I have to attack order. Problem I have here is all these order are blobbing. Like Mr. Blobby blobbing. Yeah, like a ketchup bottle first, new pop, then all at once. That's it. I think is it Tuesday nights? I often find it. It's Tuesdays or Mondays. I can't remember. It's one of the 2 days at the start of the week. Pops just go constant. Like you come out of a scenario, you re-queue, and you're straight back into another one. And it's mad just how often it happens. Ooh, Sovereign. Sovereign and Conquer. That's a weird mix.
Witch's blessing.
Genesis, okay. There's a guy wearing the Dark Promise helmet. I'm guessing that it's not Dark Promise, it's one of the greens or influence rewards that look like it, but. Okay, going off for dinner and pops, so see you later, guys. No worries, Rob. Thanks for sticking around. Hopefully, enjoy your dinner. Master Nine rank 82, White Lion. I haven't a hope in hell of killing him. As a witch elf. Hashtag nerf white lions. Doo-doo. Oh, up against. Loot of Archmages. Stabby, stabby. That was awkward. That was so unlucky. I think if I had got that Ruthless Assault off, she was in real trouble. And this is the downside of this class, is I can't get out of stealth. No way, he should have been dead. That a game. That's the thing, without the self-healing from... Is it Sacrifices Rewarded or something like that? Can't think of the name of it. It's the thing that basically heals you off the back of your Kiss of Death. I always just feel like I'm too squishy. That attempt was doomed. Time to make dinner, I guess. Hopefully you enjoy your dinner, bud. Now we're playing the waiting game of who has enough AP. God damn it. No, it was the witch hunter that it, no, sorry, it was the engineer hit me with the knockback. Yeah, it's like a 2 second cast. I probably should have put up my health, no. I was going to say I should put up my disrupt thing, but it's not a magical ability, it's a shot. I don't think I had my parry up. I always just feel like I'm too squishy as the witch elf. Where did he go? Etc. They say Magus is better than NG since magical damage, but at least NGs can't get hit by a 7 second 100% disrupt right off the bat. Yeah. Very true. Like, neither one's in a particularly good place for the majority of their leveling. Like, they only really get better once they get to the higher renown ranks, and that's just because then they get access to more defensive stuff with all their renown points and their extra mastery points. But like, you can say the same for any class. The problem with the Magus and Engineer is you can't really buff their mechanic, because if you buff it too much, you make like objective gameplay too difficult because they're too strong. And then at the same point, if you give them the ability to run and gun, why pick them over any of the other classes? Like, no way. Every time I'm about to get a killing blow on somebody, I just get stunned. I'm sorry, I didn't hear anything. I just put the food in the pan. I wasn't really saying anything. I was just complaining about the fact that I was about to kill someone and then got staggered. Oh, the energy part, I was just basically saying that them and the Magus both get stronger whenever they get higher level. But again, the same thing happens to every class, and you can't really buff either of them, because if you buff their mechanic too much, then you make keeps and forts too difficult, and if you give them the ability to run and gun, what's the point in picking a Magus or an energy over a Sorc? Or a squig herder. Or even like a DPS chamois. Like a DPS chamois would do more. And I'll miss again as I will go AFK. Just cannot get out of stealth. It's usually at this point you come out of stealth and then you want to go back into it because someone's just appeared. Well, that's the Sovereign Conqueror when I've seen the Dragon Mark. It's all Destro. Oh, they're attacking our keep. Got my dinner, now I can hear. Hopefully it's tasty. I'm going to be going to do mine a bit. I've got myself some stuffed peppers. With spicy rice. Dinner is always tasty when you live alone. That it is. It's always exactly what you want. Every time. This looks like another hopeless defeat. Come on, let me up. Thank you. I'm gonna go on doing something useful and cap the points. Right. Oh, water supplies. Entire war waging behind me and I didn't even notice. Gotcha. Non Ferocer, thank you very much for the follow, kind sir. Well, very much appreciated. Well, that got us a decent bump on our renown, calling him. These guys are all waiting around. They're getting a res from somewhere. Or maybe not. Maybe just leaving. I wonder. Well, we're not gonna know. I was gonna say, I wonder if there's anybody AFKing inside their keep. Because that feels like a thing that happens. Always got to check. Just yesterday I checked HP keep after siege free 17.7k right now. Yeah, that's the thing. It's like people just randomly seem to want to go AFK in RVR zones. I don't get it. Jesus Christ, come on guys. He was near dead. You all decided to go and fucking attack a tank. Carrick War Academy in the starter guild, join our guild. Yada yada yada. Yada yada yada. That's something I've never actually had in that in this game yet, is people spamming you to join their guild. You get it an awful lot in Star Wars The Old Republic. But you don't really get it as much here. Someone PM me a guild spam, that's an instant block. It's the annoying thing in SWTOR though, because it just pops it up in the middle of your screen. And there's no way to sort of say decline every time or something like that. You just have to constantly keep kicking it because they keep spamming you with it. Got him. Nope, out of that. Moided. Easy, make your own one-man guild. I have no real need to. I just stay in the starter guild. Or do you mean in SWTOR? If you mean in SWTOR, I've just never even bothered. Yeah, I'm in SWTOR. Yeah, I've just never bothered. Didn't have my bypass armor thing up, which is annoying. Otherwise, it would have probably got her a lot closer to death. Aye, aye, aye. Right, we'll do a wee sweep here of the keep. Doesn't seem to be anybody in here. Emptier than an empty thing in empty land. Huh. Seems like there's another witch elf in here who's had the same idea. White Landers in that last scenario. I mean, I fancied my chances against one, but not against all of them. Yoink. Have you considered streaming on 960p to make the stream less pixely? I have not. But I can certainly try. Nope, that's not what I wanted to do. I wanted to do that. Is it very pixely? Let's see if I can get up my phone. I just swapped the stream from 720p to 1440p and it's 8-bit when you move. Oh, really? Weird. Let's see. Where can I see? If I... I'll put it on my other monitor, because I can barely see anything on my phone. Twitch. My channel. Let's see. Oh yeah, I see what you mean. It's the issue with Twitch and games with things going on. Everything looks nice and cool when nothing moves, but the moment stuff starts moving, their effects appear to chunk the quality. Let's see now. Settings, output. Video? Well, I'll need to do it whenever I'm streaming a game. Yeah, I'll have a look at that and see what I can change. Right. That is pretty much everything I can do at the minute. So I'm going to end the stream there, guys. But yeah, thanks all for coming along and watching. We got completed on the Blackguard. We did a little bit in the Witch Elf. So I'm gonna have a look here and see if there's anybody streaming. Warhammer Online. Who have we got? Oh, there's a few. We'll jump over to Toth. So yeah, thank you very much for coming along, everybody. Hopefully you all enjoy the rest of your day. If I don't speak to you later on when I'm back, I hope you enjoy the rest of your evening, and I hope you have a nice day tomorrow. But until then, take care, all the best, and see ya. Bye.